Another trick with using Open Solaris is that ZFS is the partition for the root file system by default. It's pretty handy as in cases like this, for example. There's been an update and it's taken a snapshot of itself when it applied the update. The result is the update didn't go too well and the system didn't like it, and the result is I need to roll back. Fortunately, because it took a snapshot of itself, I can just select the previous snapshot and I can boot from that. Now, the difference between a ZFS snapshot and most other snapshots that you might be used to is that you might think of a snapshot taking a complete and total copy, and so it requires twice the disk space. Not so with ZFS. You can start a snapshot and it'll then record the changes and keep track of the changes. So if you're not changing that much, you won't notice that much extra file space being used. But obviously if you leave the snapshot in place, what'll happen is that over time it'll just get bigger and bigger, and it probably will eat up a maximum of twice the space as files change. So that's something to be aware of when you're using ZFS snapshots. But certainly for things like this and updates and rescuing from failed updates, it's a boon. So I'll just show you how to handle this and how to recover. Right, okay, here we are. We're now in. We're going to ask for a ZFS list with a minus R on RPool. RPool being the ZFS file system is responsible for it, and you can here see a couple of snapshots, one in Open Solaris 1, which we're running from now, and Open Solaris 2, which is the new one. You'll see it's only, well, you can see the usage. The snapshot is only using 53.7 meg, but as we change, that will get bigger. So what we need to do is get rid of the Open Solaris 2. So the first thing we need to do is ZFS promote RPool root Open Solaris -1. Right, okay, we need to go in as root, something I didn't do. I'm going to run that command again. Right, that's now promoted Open Solaris 1 and taken it off Open Solaris 2. If we now go for let's have a look. If we now go for a ZFS list minus R on RPool, you can see how things have changed. Open Solaris 1 is now 4 gig. Open Solaris 2 is 3 gig, 3.5. That's because we've reverted Open Solaris to how it was before the changes were made. And so we can assume that when the updates happened, they made 3.5 gigs worth of changes. So we're now going to delete Open Solaris 2 because the other one is promoted. So we can go ZFS delete RPool root Open Solaris -2. What is it? Promote, rename, list, destroy. Destroy is the name. So we destroy it. That's going to get rid of that pool and claim our space back. Takes a bit of time. It is taking a bit of time, isn't it? Right, it's back. We're going to ask for a list on that, and you can see that the snapshot for Open Solaris 2 has now gone. So we're back to where we were, and we can hence easily just roll back and troubleshoot it. The other thing you'd want to do is it's not under root, is it? think it's under R. Pull. R pull boot. Then there's a grub in there. So that's R pull boot grub. And under there you will find the menu LST. And that contains what you see under the boot. So you're going to want to vi into this and delete the last entry, and that will be us reverted completely back to the previous snapshot, hence undoing everything that the failed update did. And that's relatively quick. It saves us having to open, it saves us having to reinstall an operating system. So it's pretty handy to have. The trick you need to do is keep on top of the snapshots and the space used on the hard disk.